minutes after 11 with Mark. It's past 11 o'clock. Let's have a report on how things are going down at York at the Knavesmire. Here's Hugh Williams.
Thank you, Mark. Well, at the moment, 100,000 people are estimated to be swarming all over the Knavesmire here at York, and thousands more streaming in from all directions. It's quite a remarkable sight. You look out over the grandstand, you just see a sea of faces singing, chanting, and the choirs leading worship already, in fact, on the Knavesmire. It's now, of course, only just over 2 hours to go before His Holiness John Paul II flies in by helicopter to the racecourse here. It's really quite a remarkable sight. I don't think I've ever seen anything quite like it here, certainly. And the crowds are really enjoying it. There's brilliant summer sunshine. The temperature's well up in the 70s. And the ice cream stalls, too, doing a roaring trade. So, all in all, it's quite a party atmosphere here at the Knavesmire. But people are not forgetting the spiritual side of the visit by John Paul, and that can be seen in the sort of songs that are being sung and the prayers that are being said all around the course at the moment. So, this is Hugh Williams returning you now to the studio.
Hugh, thanks very much indeed. We'll be hearing more reports, of course, throughout the day from York, and especially, of course, when the Pope arrives around about 1:45. Traffic-wise, things I should think are quite hectic round about now. We'll be having a chat with our motoring correspondent, Dave Moss, see what the traffic situation is like in about 1/4 hour's time. And, of course, traffic reports throughout the day, especially when everybody starts to come back around about tea time. This is Radio T's 257 Medium Wave, 95 VHF on a bank holiday Monday at 11 past 11.
We like to think that our programmes are popular and fair, but from time to time, complaints can arise. If you feel that you have a complaint to make, it can be dealt with in various ways. By us here at Radio T's, by the Independent Broadcasting Authority, or by the new Broadcasting Complaints Commission. You can find details of the different steps you can take in a leaflet available from this station. If you want a copy, then write to us at Radio T's, 74 Dafcott Street, Stockton-on-Tees, Cleveland.
This Bank Holiday Monday, you're invited to see the best in furniture from Great Britain, Scandinavia and the continent at Barker & Stonehouse of Middlesbrough and Darlington. Barker & Stonehouse for a world of beautiful furniture. Barker & Stonehouse are open Bank Holiday Monday in Middlesbrough and Darlington, and there's ample car parking at the rear of the stores.
sunshine. It's lovely. If you're in the back garden, it's all right for some people. 12 minutes past 11 o'clock, Dennis will be on the beach at Seaton around about half past 11. He'll have a real ace tan now, if he's not busy with a candy floss. Here's Stevie Wonder and Do I Do. Do you remember the exciting Joe 90? We'll be remembering him after this. Do I do? 11:17. Ball Hill Farm near Lanchester in County Durham is up once again this bank holiday, so you can watch sheep shearing, sheep dogs at work, ploughing, spraying and farm machinery demonstrations. Ball Hill Farm is open this Saturday between 1 and 4 and is 4 miles along the B6296 Lanchester to Walsingham Road, 50p to get in, free to park your car. And Stocksley Roundtable's Pram Race is held this afternoon with me, Mark Quedge, along there to set it all going around about 2 o'clock this afternoon. It's 11:17. Now, do you remember Joe 90 on the telly? Who have we gone through this morning? We've gone through Stingray, we've gone through Supercar, and now Joe 90. Do you remember him? He was only a lad of 10, but he could fight all the secret agents in the world and Grangetown. His dad, a scientist, had made him some magic glasses which could be programmed to make him whatever he wanted to be in his brain. He could program his glasses so that Joe 90 could become a brain surgeon. So that he could become a borough player. So that he could play cricket. So that he could become a top secret scientist. Or somebody really highly intelligent. Or, if you wanted to make him deaf, he could make him a DJ.
Hello, this is Peter Matthews.
That was Joe 90. Something else that's happening today. Tees Cottage Pumping Station is open to the public today until 5:30 tonight. The pumping station is situated at Connorscliffe Road in Darlow and it's 50p and 20p to get in. If I see you tonight, I'm discoing in Saltburn tonight. I'd like to be down there now, you know, because it's nice and sunny in there. And the sea. There's an arts and crafts fair at Helmsley Town Hall until 5 o'clock tonight. 15p to get in. Children and senior citizens for free. And there's live music at the Buck Jazz Club Monday night at 8 in the Westgate in Gisborough. Records. Don't like like his jumpers, though. Well, that stool he rocks on. Well, there we are. Val Doonican and Runaway. Right, it's 22 minutes past 11 o'clock. Time for some more motoring. How are things going on the roads to York? Dave Moss.
Well, things are changing quite dramatically now. The peak traffic seems to have left the 257 area and is now sort of south of Easingwold on the A19. Light traffic is being reported on the dual carriageway at Thirsk, where the A19 joins the A168, although the police tell us that quite a lot of people are using an alternative route, which is quite a sensible thing in the circumstances, really, and instead of leaving to go on the A19 down to York, are actually continuing along the dual carriageway, the A168, down to the Dishforth roundabout of, on the A1, and then travelling south on the A1 and getting into York from the west, which is quite a good idea. And in fact, the police are suggesting that if anybody else wants to follow that route, they don't see any reason why you shouldn't do that. It does mean, however, that you'll end up in the west car park rather than the north one, so you'll have to come the same way home, as you won't be able to travel through York. And the B1363, which is another road from the north into York, has got quite heavy traffic on it, and apparently people on that road are trying to continue into York town or York city centre itself, which they're not being able, not being allowed to do, because you need a pass today to get into York centre. So if you don't have a pass, then there is no point at all in trying to get into York town centre, which is now fairly heavily congested, I'm told, by just by the local traffic within the boundaries. Another subject, this evening or this afternoon, when people are leaving York, the police are recommending that you stagger your journey time home. So if you want to have a look around the city, or, you know, walk along the walls, or down by the river there, then that's an ideal opportunity, because there is no way that all these people who are congregating in York at this moment are going to be able to leave together. And one trouble spot that the police are anticipating is at Catterick roundabout, where there's a contraflow system due to roadworks. So if you were intending to travel north up the A1, be prepared for some fairly long delays there. And one other piece of traffic news not associated with the Pope's visit is very heavy traffic leaving Scotch Corner to go up towards the Lake District, is being reported. So if you're on that stretch of road, you can be prepared for some fairly lengthy delays. There's an awful lot of traffic there. If you're still on the move, then take it nice and easy. Leave plenty of room between your cars. And if you're stuck in a traffic jam, then all I can say is be patient.
Shall we be following games tonight, though, with everybody coming back from all directions?
I think that's right, Mark. And, of course, we'll be trying to keep you up to date with the very latest traffic information here on Radio Tees.
Dave, thank you very much. It's 11:24.
Around each other, trying so hard to stay warm. That first cold winter together, lying in each other's arms, watching those old leaves falling in love so desperately. Honey, I was your hero. Thank you.
sunshine today. No need to put the lunch in the oven today. Just keep it outside for a while. 11:27 here on 257. Well, other than the obvious traffic problems of going into York today, Cleveland police are warning that bank holiday traffic is building up in Cleveland, especially around Gisborough. A combination of families en route to Whitby and racecourse travelling to Redcar means all the roads into Gisborough are congested. And at one point, there's a two-mile tailback. The A171, the A174 and the A19 South should be steered clear of, if at all possible. So, not only around about York, but also around Gisborough, traffic problems and also lots of people on the way to Whitby and to Redcar this afternoon. And this morning, it's 11:28, here's Dana. And in about 3 or 4 minutes, Dennis from Seaton Carew with the Lava. I feel love coming on, that's Dana, and it's 11:31, next we go over to Seaton Carew and hear from Dennis, here on 257.
The MFI sale is still on, and now there are thousands of new bargains for every room in your home. The biggest choice of styles and finishes. Crazy prices with 50, 60, even 75% off. You've got to see it to believe it. The MFI sale, on now, and open holiday Monday, 10 till 6.
MFI. Your food taking extra care. Right price deal for low.
Bargains only at your local Co-op Price Fighter this week. Co-op white sliced bread, 800 grams, 29.5p. 2 pints fresh milk, 35.5p. 5 ounce Co-op yogurt, only 12p.
You're caring, sharing Co-op. Caring, sharing Co-op. You're caring, sharing Co-op.
Save money right now at the MFI Superstore, Mandale Triangle, Thornaby. Also at Darlington and Sunderland.
MFI.
There's a sale on now.
257
meters, 95 VHS. Today's a day where the sun shines. Today's a day where it's 11:32 in the morning. Only 28 minutes of this morning left before it's din din time. I'm having dinner in Stokesley today, like. I don't have lunch, mate. I have dinner, and then I have tea. Me, I have tea. Not the drink, but the meal. Okay, let's go over to Seaton Crewe now, and around about 9:30, Dennis was there with his pneumatic drill. Let's cross over to Seaton see if there's been any change. Hello, Dennis.
Hello. Hey, Mark. Thanks very much, mate. Thank you very much indeed. Yeah, back on the beach here. Well, you can hardly call it a beach now. Just a lump of rock that is the beach at Seaton now. I have with me Mr. Brian Allibert, who is the chairman of the Federation of the Seaton Crewe Chip Shops. Brian, hello.
Thank you all very much indeed.
It's all right, Brian. How are you doing, mate?
Well, I'm not too bad, Dennis.
I'm all right for those fish and chips later.
Two halibut, or did you want a cod?
Quiet now, till later. We're on the radio. No, Brian here is currently offered assistance. I'm going to have one last go at getting shot of the lava off the beach here with my pneumatic drill. No, it's not coming away, Dad. It's just not working.
You're not pushing hard enough, Dennis.
I'm pushing hard. My teeth have come out now. Just a minute, I'll put my teeth. Oh, my false teeth came out there, like, that wasn't very good. There's only one thing left. Now, Brian, you've brought along all the vinegar in the chip shops in Seaton to see if that'll melt the lava on the beach. See if it dissolves it, like, you know, like sugar dissolves in tea.
Well, the acidic properties of vinegar are renowned around the world for dissolving rock, so I thought if I brought 30 gallons, then we'd be all right. What do you think, Dennis?
Firstly, I think people who come for chips and Seaton like are going to be a bit upset, Brian, because when they come for a good time, they won't get the smack of vinegar as the chips hit their mouths, sometimes going right inside.
But we only get through 30 gallon a day, so it's only for one day.
That's one day of upset people in Seaton. Well, that happens quite often anyway. Okay, Brian, now you've got the big 10 gallon thing there. Perhaps you can give the side of the can a big twang?
Okay, Dennis.
Oh, that sounds fairly healthy. Right, perhaps you can start pouring it on the lava now, Brian, okay?
Okay, Dennis, I'll just pull the ring on the top.
Hey, be careful where you're pouring that, I don't want to splash my boats, like.
Hey, it seems to be working, Dennis.
It's frothing all over, like.
It's frothy, man.
Oh, look, it's bubbling around the lava, but... It's just bubbling all the way through back on the beach below. It's not doing anything at all. It's just disappearing through the holes in the lava lake.
What we need, Dennis, is a catalyst. Have you brought your cat?
No, I had a bit of tension with our cat this morning. Do you know what happened?
What was that?
Well, I heard this crash in the kitchen, like, this smash of a milk bottle, like, and I went through, and this milk bottle was smashed on the floor. I said to the cat, have you done that? He said, me, yow. Hey, this vinegar's useless, it's done now.
It's second vinegar.
What do you mean? You've scraped it off the chips?
Aye.
That's pathetic. Last time I come to get vinegar on my chips is Seaton.
Hey, you wanted a halibut off me? You get no halibut from me, pal.
Just watch it, Char.
Hey, oh, you do. Hey, what? Hey, come on, then.
Hey, wait. I've got a mate called Gormless Garden, and he could... Anyway, listen.
Get your fist up, yo. Get your fist up. Come
on. Hang on a minute. Hey, away. Mind me glasses. Now then, I'd just like to say thank you, Brian. Thank you very much indeed.
Okay. Thank you as well, Dennis.
Thank you.
Last time I bring my second-hand vinegar down on Seaton Beach with
you. Last time I invite you, mate.
Okay. Oh, no more halibuts, that's all I'm saying.
Mind me glasses.
Right.
Okay. Well, we seem to have a problem here at Seaton. The lava won't shift even for vinegar or pneumatic.
Last time I come down, Dennis.
Yeah, fair enough, Brian. Now, the thing is...
I'm not coming down
here. Yes, we can hear. Go away. Walk off. Go and walk the donkeys on the beach.
You walk off.
Yes, you walk off. Now, the thing is, Mac, there's only one cure, and do you know what that is, Mac?
What's that, Dennis? What can we do? What can we get as a cure if nothing, not even the vinegar from the Seaton Crewe chip shops, can cure it? What can we do, Dennis?
There's only one place to go. There's no place on earth that can now provide that cure. I must now go into outer space. I will become the first astronaut from Middlesbrough!
Well, will Dennis really become the first man from Middlesbrough to go into space? Will he follow such famous names as Captain Kirk, Flash Gordon, he got 6 months, Neil Armstrong, Vanessa Slug, the first woman in space? As he steps out onto the launch pad at Cape South Bank and gets the okay for takeoff from Mission Control, Ferry Hill, what will in fact be going through Dennis's mind, if he has one?
I wish I was a spaceman, the fastest guy alive. I'd fly you round the universe in Fireball XL5. Way out in space together, conquerors of the skies. My heart would be a fireball. We'd take the path to Jupiter, then maybe very soon. We'd cruise along the Milky Way and land upon the moon. Through a wonderland of stardust, we'd zoom away to Mars. My heart would be a fireball, a fireball. 'Cause you would be my Venus of the stars.
Can you imagine it? Dennis in space. Imagine Dennis if he stepped out onto the surface of the moon. And know what he would say? He would say, "Mac, this place is like Ayrton Park. There's no atmosphere." Listening to me, Mark, on the Brekkie Show every morning, 5 till 9, over the coming weeks, for news of Dennis, the first astronaut from Middlesbrough. Do you know what I mean? 18 minutes to 12.
This bank holiday Monday evening, between 7 and 10, join me, Dave Brown, for 3 hours of the Motown Special. All your favourites, including Junior Walker and the All-Stars, The Temptations, and The Four Tops. Plus, your chance to win one of half a dozen of the latest Motown Chartbuster albums. I'll be there. That's 3 hours of the best in Motown, from the 60s up to the present day. This bank holiday Monday between 7 and 10 with me, Dave Brown, on tees.
Dave Brown will be there tonight. 17 minutes to 12, okay. Have you got the lunch on yet? You have. Oh, that's smashing. Don't forget mine with chips. Now then, in an American town in the days of the Wild West, a man new to town went up to one of the town people and said,
"Can you tell me whereabouts I can borrow some money? I need a few dollars."
And the townsman said,
"Yep. See that fella over there on the white horse and his Indian friend, Tonto?" He said, "Yep." He said, "All right, well, we're going to have a word with him. He's the Lone Ranger."
The man who thought Slim Panatello was a country and western singer, John Cain. 12 minutes to 12.
Element Travel are now British rail agents. That means you can treat your local Element Travel office just like a railway station booking office. You can buy tickets and rail cards, reserve seats. In fact, whatever you'd normally find at a station booking office is now at Element, and you only pay station prices. Make your rail booking at Element Travel. Bishop Auckland, Darlington, Durham, Eston, Gisborough, Hartlepool, Middlesbrough, North Allerton, Redcar and Stockton. Element Travel, your local rail station in the High Street.
Fireside rug to a three-pin plug, from a window latch to a cupboard catch, from a kitchen tile to a velvet pile, so you can shop late with Open Till 8. You'll see more for less when you're in Focus.
Focus, we're open for your home improvement needs. Yes, we're open for all your home improvement needs. That's Focus at Lynn Street, Hartlepool.
Not only today the obvious problem of traffic around York, but Cleveland Police warn that bank holiday traffic is building up in the Cleveland area, especially around Gisborough. Combination of families en route to Whitby, and also racecourse travelling to Redcar, means all the roads into Gisborough are congested. At one point there's a 2 mile tailback. The A171, the A174 and the A19 south should be cleared of if at all possible. But there we are, Gisborough is another problem point today. 11:12 with Mark. Here's the Associates with Club Country. Start the place, Martin.